Hello friends, welcome to this video on areas of parallelograms and triangles. In the previous video, we solved some questions based on the area of parallelograms on the same base and between the same parallel lines. Today, we will discuss some facts related to parallelograms on the same base and between the same parallel lines. So let's start with the first question. In the given figure, the areas of parallelogram JKLM and rectangle JKON are same. Can you tell whether the perimeters of parallelogram JKLM and rectangle JKON will be same or not? In the given figure, parallelogram JKLM and rectangle JKON have a common side, side JK. We can say that their base is also same, which is side JK. We know that a rectangle is also a parallelogram. So we can say that these two parallelograms lie between the same parallel lines, JK and MO. We know that the area of these two parallelograms will be equal. Can you explain why? Yes, because the areas of parallelograms lying on the same base and between the same parallel lines are equal. But can we say the same for their perimeter as well? Let us write the perimeter of both quadrilaterals. The perimeter of parallelogram JKLM is the sum of the lengths of all sides JK plus KL plus LM plus MJ, and the perimeter of rectangle JKON is JK plus KO plus ON plus NJ. Friends, the formula for the perimeter of a parallelogram is 2, the sum of opposite sides. And since the opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal, we can write it like this also. For parallelogram JKLM as 2JK and plus 2MJ, and for rectangle JKLM as 2JK plus 2NJ. Here, 2JK is common to both sides. Therefore, to compare the perimeter of parallelogram JKLM and rectangle JKON, we have to compare their sides MJ and NJ. We can write it like this. Can you tell what would be the relation between the two? Will these two be equal? Let me give you a hint. We can see that in triangle JNM, JNM is a right angle triangle where the side opposite angle JNM is hypotenuse JM. And we know that the hypotenuse is always greater than other sides. Therefore, we can say that side JM will be greater than JN, or let's say MJ greater than NJ. Thus, it leads to the conclusion that the perimeter of a parallelogram is greater than the perimeter of a rectangle. Friends, with this, let us end this session. In this session, we discussed some facts based on the area of parallelograms on the same base and between the same parallel lines. See you in the next video. Thank you.